All right, we're off. Bit of a slow start to get my day going here. It's November 6th, Sunday morning. Brisk, but bright and beautiful. We'll see if the sun holds up. Today, we are just hoping to catch a fish. I have very low expectations because I will freely admit, I struggle the most in fishing when the water is below 50 degrees. I was here last weekend, the water was 48 degrees. That's pretty cold. I'm assuming it's gonna be closer to 45 today. And that's gonna make the fishing very, very tough. Good thing about this place is it is overpopulated with fish. Bad news is there's barely anything bigger than a pound, but my best chances of catching fish really, really early in the season and really late, you know, again, anything with water temps below 50, this is the place I like to come to. Because again, it's a weakness of mine, trying to catch fish in less than 50 degree water temps. So we have a game plan. We've had luck in the past working a black and blue jig, either just a regular football head, 3/8 ounce with a crawfish trailer, or we'll fish a 3/8 ounce football jig with just a hula grub, probably about a 4-inch one, again, black and blue. We'll work that for a little bit. We'll work the windblown shore with some jerk baits and spinner baits, because even though the water temp is below 50, typically you wouldn't find much luck with spinner baits in that. Every year I catch them out here in that spinner bait, even when the water's like 45. So we'll give it a shot just because, you know, history has taught us that it works. In the meantime, we're gonna beat along this bank here because there is a fairly steep drop and there's lots of wood and stuff. I've caught fish kind of cruising about 30 feet offshore here where it breaks down to about 6 feet. But right now we're on a shelf where it's only about 2 or 3 feet deep right here. Do the best we can, and hopefully that wind doesn't mess with my mic today. For those curious, if you are looking, yes, I am wearing snowboard pants because it is cold. It was 40 degrees air temp when I got here, and there's a decent breeze about 10 miles an hour. There's a chance it might pick up, but it's cold enough that even with that breeze, it's kind of tearing right through me. I've got multiple layers on for shirts. Like I said, I got my snowboard pants on, but I'm feeling pretty good right now. My hands are cold. There's nothing you can ever do about that. I've yet to find a pair of gloves that work well enough while I'm fishing. But other than that, I'm feeling all right. So the game plan with how I'm gonna work this jig is try and work it very, very slow. Everything's moving slow in the water, so I wanna make that move slow to imitate that. I'm gonna drag it along the bottom, keeping it contacted on the bottom, only about 6 inches at most at a time. And then just kind of at random patterns, just a quick little snap of the wrist, I wanna get that jig to pop up off the ground, only a couple of inches. I don't want the thing to come skyrocketing up even like a foot. Certainly not like 3 or 4 feet. I just want it to hop a little bit. I want it to look like a very lethargic crayfish that is moving along, taking its time, trying to scurry, and every once in a while a little hop. Just if there is anything nearby that can't see it as it's going flat across the bottom, that little subtle hop will be enough to hopefully catch their attention.
Got him!
Ha! Hey, that's a better fish for here. He's not huge, but beautiful colors on him. Look at that line. Well, at least on my side, yeah. Beautiful, beautiful colors, and he's been eating really well too. He's not fat, but he's got some meat on him. They're eating well. I don't know, maybe a pound and a half, pound and a quarter. Nice fish regardless. Good stuff. So I'm working this really subtle cove, and it's really shallow shelf up top with a bunch of boulders, and then the boulders drop off to a steep bank out here where it goes down about 8 to 10 feet. So what I was doing with the jig was working that deepest point in the end to 8 to 10 foot range where there's a bunch of big boulders, but then a bunch of little boulders all scattered around the base of them too. And I was working the jig down in there and just kind of, you know, just twitching it, hopping it along instead of dragging it so that I don't get stuck underneath any boulders. And I just felt a little tick-tick as I went over the rocks, and then thump, and then chomp-chomp as he's pulling line away. So So able to pick him up pretty easily. We're gonna keep doing that and see if that pays off for the rest of the day. Got him. That's a better fish. Little guy. Beautiful colors on him though. Well, there was a fish here that's gone now. Oh! He's not! Dude, really? That is the best feeling. And look at this fish! I mean, from like 2 feet in front of me. That's a solid fish for this place. Look at this one! That is a beautiful smallmouth. I haven't caught a smallmouth that big here. Oh man! Ah, risky. I don't know why I tried to do that.